Thank you, ma'am. I stand here on behalf of the MCP on the supplementary demands for grants. I do understand that this entire budget has come during exceptionally challenging times. And globally, the pandemic has really put every country, every state, every human being and family under absolutely unnatural pressures. So during these challenging times, and I'd like to thank an issue this morning raised by Nitin Gadkari ji. He was very complimentary to the government of Maharashtra and especially the finance minister of Maharashtra for giving a very good budget during these challenging times. And we are looking to work closer with this government because cooperative federalism and supporting each other during these challenging times is really the need of the hour. So I would like to just highlight a few points which government of Maharashtra and the state of central government, I think we could work together to deliver superior results to people of the country who are really suffering in these challenging times. I would like to go back to a couple of points just to highlight them and reiterate them which Professor Roy spoke in his speech. I think he talked about fiscal deficit and he talked about monetizing land. We are not against monetizing. Somebody else from the other side immediately corrected and said, "Aapke time mein hua tha, zarur hamare time mein hua tha." It was a very progressive policy that we had done of restructuring and trying out PPP models which would work. But I think the concern that he was raising was that this time is an extra aggressive effort to monetize, especially in departments which is railways, telecom, road, power, youth, civil aviation, petroleum, shipping and ports. And if the Honorable Minister would kindly clarify, is even LIC. Now, I understand that a certain amount of disinvestment is need of the hour when we are all in the global game. But aggressively, from what we read in the newspapers, is why is this government in such a big hurry for 8 mantralayas, 8 ministries, which are all lucrative businesses for the government and LIC? So if you could kindly clarify this question.
Sir, ant mein bole.
Madam? I just want to clarify that the LIC is not privatization, ma'am.
Since the members asked for the clarification, I would allow minister to clarify. If the clarification was
better for us,
मैंने सिर्फ इतना ही कहना है कि LIC की कोई privatization नहीं हो रही, उसका केवल public issue आने की बात हो रही है.
IPO.
दोनों में बहुत अंतर है.
IPO.
IPO.
But still, the government shares would be diluted with the IPO. So it's still, you are not selling it completely, but net comes back to the same thing.
But that's how money is raised.
Yeah, but that could be a real, but we have serious concerns about it. That's all we are trying to flag. The other point which he made, I think, which the Honorable Finance Minister also clarified, is about the money given to the poor. I think the point which Professor Roy was trying to make is, compared to America, the amount of investment made in these accounts which was started during the UPA, you were also a part of this house that time when Chidambaram ji talked about every household and every human citizen of India must have an account, was started at that time. Anyway, governance is something which is continuity. So it's not about you did it. We started it, we continued it. So we are very flattered that you took few of our policies ahead. We are very happy about it. But the point I think he was trying to make is 6,000 rupees is not good enough. And you gave 500 rupees 3 times. So it's 1,500 rupees, which is really not enough. So I think the point he was trying
chicken
to drive
feed.
Was chicken. It was chicken feed. If I think we need a lot more money to be invested in the system for the economy to boom, otherwise it's not going to take off. The other point he made was about petrol and diesel. I won't go, he's already spoken, but I would like to make a small intervention about LPG, which is very, very important. And I'm so glad there's a lady sitting at the helm of affairs, so she will probably understand this much faster than any other man. I don't want to get into the gender trap, but we do balance our homes. I still remember the Honorable Prime Minister had come for a Ujjwala Yojana program to Maharashtra. It was a very big program. We were also excited about it. And if achhe ko to achha bolna hi chahiye. So if he was doing it with the right intention, he had given 8 crore Ujjwala Yojana connection. That connection was given in Maharashtra. And this story was done by Mr. Krishna Kende. I would like to bring him because he did this story very effectively. And he said there was a lady called Aisha Sheikh who lived in Ajanta. She got that thing. And she said that cylinder to pehli baar mil gaya, लेकिन अभी भाव 800 रुपया है, जो जिस घर में वो रहती है उसका भाड़ा 600 रुपया है और सिलेंडर का भाव 800 रुपया है। तो अभी सिलेंडर घर में रहे कि खाना खा के पकाए, क्या करे? सो आई थिंक यू नीड टू क्लैरिफाई दिस स्टैंड। एंड देयर इज अनदर लेडी मंदाबाई फ्रॉम पैठण, आई एम पर्पसली गिविंग द नेम्स सो दे आर नॉट हाइपोथेटिकल। दिस इज उज्ज्वला स्कीम। सर कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स हैकल करे तो अभी क्या कुछ बचा ही नहीं फिर पार्लियामेंट्री डेमोक्रेसी में। सो दिस मंदाबाई फ्रॉम पैठण एंड आयशा शेख फ्रॉम अजंठा, दीज वर गिवन सर्टिफिकेट्स इन द उज्ज्वला योजना बाय द गवर्नमेंट। सो आई थिंक आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क दिस क्लैरिफिकेशन ऑफ दिस गवर्नमेंट एंड द ऑनरेबल फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर इन वन ऑफ हिज आई थिंक रिप्लाइज लास्ट वीक सेड दैट स्टेट्स मस्ट हेल्प एंड स्टेट्स एंड द सेंटर गवर्नमेंट शुड वर्क टुगेदर इन रिड्यूसिंग पेट्रोल एंड डीजल प्राइसेस। The problem is GST money has not come. So states don't have money for their social sector programs. हमारे जो गरीब है, शोषित है, पीड़ित है, वंचित है, उनके जो social sector programs है, आपने जो GST का पैसा नहीं दिया, delay किया, उसमें उनके सारे programs रुके पड़े हैं। ये जो डिजिटल डिवाइड हो रहा है आज बच्चों के पैंडेमिक के कारण, उसमें हमारे पैसे नहीं जा पा रहे, और ऊपर से अगर हम और भी पेट्रोल और डीजल में भी जो 10 पैसे हमको मिल रहे हैं सरकार को किसी, वो भी अगर दे दे तो खाने क्या ही मुश्किल हो जाएगा स्टेट्स को। सो आई थिंक दिस गवर्नमेंट नीड्स टू बी अ लिटिल मोर एम्पथेटिक एंड रियली सी द नंबर्स बिफोर दे आस्क अस टू मेक सच इंटरवेंशन। सो आई मेक अ हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट विद द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर टू हेल्प अस विद दिस GST रिलीफ। देन देर इज़ अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग स्पीच विच ऑनरेबल लीडर फ्रॉम द BJP मेड, हिज नेम इज तपिर गोवा, राइट? आई कुड बी प्रोनाउंसिंग तपिर गाव। He made some very interesting suggestions. He talked about vaccination and he said the Prime Minister created the vaccine in Atmanirbhar Bharat. I'm very happy about it and it doesn't really matter who takes credit for it. But I just want to tell him that, just 2 minutes, I'll wrap it up with the clarification, that these companies that he's talked about in Atmanirbhar Bharat, which were started by the Honorable Prime Minister, just to flag them, they were all started in the 70s. Atmanirbhar Bharat, made in India. 1970 में सीरम इंस्टीट्यूट जब बनी थी वो पूना में की कंपनी है। एवरी ग्लोबली चाइल्ड जो पोलियो हो, ड्रॉप्स या बाकी कोई आजार हो, वो सारी वैक्सीन पूना डिस्ट्रिक्ट में महाराष्ट्र में बनती है। जरूर आत्मनिर्भर भारत है, लेकिन ये 1980 वाला आत्मनिर्भर भारत है। एंड सिंस आई एम शॉर्ट ऑफ टाइम, आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू गेट इन टू डिटेल्स, बट आई वॉन्ट टू आस्क अ पॉइंटेड क्वेश्चन टू द ऑनरेबल फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर दैट यू हैव पुट आउट 35,000 crores फॉर वैक्सीनेशन। वाई इज दिस ड्राइव वेन वी हैव इनफ वैक्सीन अवेलेबल इन इंडिया? वाई इज दिस नॉट इन फुल फ्लेज्ड process? I want to ask him this. Why are we not going for universal vaccination, which is the need of the hour, except in state like mine, Karnataka, where you're ruling, the cases are going up. So why is universal vaccination not being encouraged if you have 35,000 crores already allocated? Then he talked about defense. The same member was talking about defense. I just want to flag it very quickly because I'm short of time, that in defense, please get it on record that the monies for the Air Force and the Navy, the budget has gone down. It has not gone up. Then Bharat talked about Narega. I think the Honorable Finance Minister has already made a statement that government may increase Narega spending if it arises, which is a statement. I would like to ask a pointed question that why have you not got it in the supplementary of demands when Narega is under this kind of pressure? So the demand is there. Why is government not being proactive? Just the last point, that the budget's big worry is the food subsidy. We appreciate the interventions done by the government when the challenging times. There were 3 departments who worked exceptionally well with us. One was railways, the food subsidy, as well as external affairs. We are very grateful for the work they have done for us in feeding the poor. But the food subsidy, I think there's no clarity in this budget vis-a-vis FCI, because FCI will have to resort to further borrowing from NSSF, possibly to the tune of 150 crores. You see what is happening in Punjab and Haryana. There is so much unrest in this. And if there is no clarity on FCI, I would request the Honorable Minister to do this and find a solution for cooperative federalism. There are a couple of more points, but I think since we're short of time, I appreciate you giving to time. But I would like to ask a pointed question on health, which you're going on and on. What are you committed to, universal vaccination in this country or not? I expect you to give me a reply. Thank you for indulging me. Thank you, ma'am.